minutes later, and he's like, Nicole, mom's dead. I'm like, what? You're kidding me? Tell me you're lying. He's like, no, she was murdered last night. And then I just saw my whole life just completely fall apart.
As experiences often, it's about the police and prosecutors, people who are killed at home are most likely to be killed by someone close to them. That this was not a random act, that it was committed by someone who knew her and someone who had the opportunity to kill her, most likely her husband.
She's been killing my wife. They just wanted me to break down and say they did it or paid somebody to do it. I knew I didn't do it.
Cops took me down to the Pennsylvania State Police Barracks, where they had my brother and my father.
I just remember coming around the corner from the door, and just running to me, and just grabbing her and holding her, giving her a hug. Because I just, there's nothing I could do for her. Nothing I could do to make it better. I just held on to her.
We both kind of just wanted to rewind time. I never asked myself once if my dad killed my mom because I just knew. My mom had no enemies. She's just a great personality and was just loved by everybody. So it was kind of like, why would someone want to hurt her? And who would do it? Who could be such a monster? Shortly after the attack, we had to go to and see our attacker. He was kept in a plexiglass, bulletproof partition. On the other side.
They're going to put
just looked like a kid's
animal.
He was disgusting. He wouldn't stop staring at me. And that was the worst feeling in the entire world.
I wanted to leap over the railing, actually, because I was so angry at that point. And I really wanted to get a punch in or something.
There was no way that we could allow this guy to hit the streets. The judge held Lane without bail, finding that he was a danger to